Hey there, this is Satvik Das. Welcome to my channel Art and Print. And if you don't know me, I do pencil drawing.
In this very video, I'll be sharing with you my ways of visualizing pencil art and share some tips that were beneficial to me.
So for your convenience, I'll be dividing this video into three easy steps. Now the first one being the materials that I use.
Materials unknowingly play a key role to give your drawing a life. Starting off with this, it's a mechanical pencil. I use it mainly for drawing the outlines. The reason why I love it the most is it's cheap, affordable, and you need not sharp it all the time. You just need to grab one and start marking your outlines. Now for the paper, I trust ivory papers from Oxford the most. The quality in this price range is commendable. For cross hatches and little blending, this goes the best for me. Now if you want to target hyperrealism, I would say a good quality cartridge paper will do. I don't prefer buying a very rough one as it cuts off the smooth blending effect, giving it a very rough and different tone. Another must-have is a kneadable eraser. Yes, my friend, kneadable erasers are nothing but a blessing. You can actually press them into any shape you want it to be. Secondly, unlike other erasers, it absorbs the graphite and reduces the chance of smudging your drawing. This clay eraser finally grips in your hand, avoiding it to slip away. Now you must have heard of blending stumps. They're actually paper compressed in a form of pencils. I usually use them for dissolving the graphite dust. It helps you deliver the realistic touch easily. So it's highly recommended.
Now secondly, I'll be targeting the process of hyperrealism. Now you need to hear this very carefully.
Now to begin with, always start your works with a base layer of shade. It's the foundation. And my friend, take as much as time as you can, but do analyze your reference very well. It not only helps you towards perfection, but increases your observation power. I generally prefer high grade pencils like 6B, 8B or 10B because they are soft and they leave no marks when erased. And they also help in adding contrast to your drawing.
Now the third and last, you need to add your own signature. Now signature never means I'll teach you to write your own name. You know it better than me. By signature here I mean your own unique way, your own signature styles which you can use, the highlights or little very effects that you can add into your drawing to make it yours, so that the viewer who is watching your video, he should feel that urge to know you.
And lastly, the most important tip out of all, practice. Yes, my friend. The more you practice, the more you'll excel.
So if you really find my ways productive, do provide with a like. Yes, it inspires me. And if you're new to my channel, do consider subscribing. Yes, I promise, your subscription won't get wasted. Thanks for the time. Keep drilling, keep practicing. Stay safe.